Hi, hello, welcome back to my channel Dad Spencer's Things. In this HTML tutorials, up to now we have seen about basics, elements, attributes of HTML and headings and paragraphs, styles and text formatting and everything we have seen in the previous sessions. If you have not watched those videos, go through those videos which is in the playlist of HTML V3 schools. So go through my channel and subscribe it and you watch those videos. They are in the order and given in a playlist, so you can follow that order. Today we are going to see about all about the HTML annotations and citations elements. So let's see what is meant by these elements. In this chapter we will go through these block quote and queue, abbreviation and address and site and bidirectional tags. What is all these about HTML elements, what these tags indicates or defines, we will gonna see too for today. This is the example of the quote we have taken from this WWF website. You can see here, this is a website seen in that website. I'm taking that type content from that website and using in my web page. Then you can include that paragraph or which is the content you wanna include in your web page from the another source. You can give it in a black quote tag and you can cite it where, from which web page, from which reference you have get this particular text, you can include here. By that you will get to know if the author have seen your content in your web page. Without giving any copyright claim, he will contact you because you have mentioned something as a reference here. So that kind of things can be done by using this block quote. But now I think is everyone is clear with this example, like given black quote in that, in the tag mentioned, we have to give the content which you have extracted from the other source. Now come to the definition of a black quote. Now you can see here, HTML black quote element defines a section that is quoted from the another source. From the another source, we have taken that content and we have including in our web page. So browsers usually indent these block quote elements. You can see here, this is another example, same which I have seen in the earlier stage. This is the paragraph cited from this WWF website, which is a worldwide life website. From this website, under these HTML URLs, we have extracted this. So you can include in your web page by using this block quote. So next we will gonna see about quotations, which is a short quotations. By use a small q tag, which is a small q tag defines a short quotation. Do you want a short quotation your content, you can use this tag. Browsers usually insert these quotation marks around those quotation. The content which you wanna be in your quotations, that it should be included in this tag, that is a q tag. Let's try this example so that you will understand that. Here I am giving a paragraph of WWF goal is to colon, and in that I am giving a q quotation, q tag. With that I am giving a quotation to the particular content which to be included in this tag. So I get the output like build a future where people live in the harmony with nature is to be in quotation. So I am using here q. For example, any title want to be in a quotations or any special thing, then you can use this tag and give them quotations in this HTML by this element. So that is a small q. And we have another tag called attribute element, which is abbreviation we can specify with ABBR. ABBR is a tag which defines abbreviation or acronym, like HTML is an abbreviation, CSS, Mr., Doctor, SF and ATM. Like these abbreviations are many things. So if you wanna give abbreviation which indicates that that form, you can use those abbreviation by indicate those abbreviation by using this tag. Marking abbreviation can give an information to the browsers or translation systems or search engines. By using this, if someone searches for HTML by using full form, you will get to retrieve. The browser engines will get to know the things easily by giving this type of things to the browser. It will retrieve or get the information very fastly by specifying all these things. It's very best for a developer to write all these things and follow for a creation of a better website. So let's see this example of abbreviation where we have given the paragraph in which I am nesting the ABBR tag. In the starting tag, we have to include the title. We have seen discussed earlier in the previous sessions. We can see we have discussed about title. Title, I am giving a World Health Organization. Title means what? Nothing but if you place your cursor on that particular content, you will see that title is a cursor tab, a toggle, and the toggle you can see the full form of that we can give, or either if you can don't give this title, it won't be matter. I'm cutting this and giving only abbreviation, it will be okay. Abbreviation, if you put the cursor on that, it will do not give you the full form on the toggle. If you write to give extra information to the user who have visited your website, you have to be include the title, then he will got to know what is this WHO. If he didn't know what the full form of WHO, he got to know by clicking on that or putting cursor on that. The toggle will be displayed here. You can see the World Health Organization, it is displayed. So likewise, you can do the things by using this ABBR. And next is similar paragraph is nothing but P tag. So this is all about abbreviation tag, and also we have an address tag, which this tag describes the contact information for an author or owner or the particular site or document or article or which author it has written. So to give that kind of information in your site, you can use this address tag. The contact information can be of anything, for example, maybe of email address or URL or physical address, maybe, or maybe his phone number or social media handle of Instagram or LinkedIn, anything. You can specify in your web page under the contact information by using this address tag. This address tag rendered in italic form, it gives a special preference to the text, and browser will always add a new break line after and before this address element, so that it will be in a separate form and it will be visible to the user in a quick manner, and it will have a special added advantage if you have that address content in this address tag. It will be print address as an address without making it as a paragraph, it makes it as a unique, that it resembles it as an address of that author or particular thing. By specifying the address, you can get these things. The text will be in a default and italic form. And if you can mention it as BR in the break line, you can get it the difference in the different lines. In a new line, you will get this. So you can see the address tag here. They have written the address written by author name and visitors. Some website address is given, and his physical address he is also given here. So this type of addresses can be included in that tag is address tag. So it gives a special preference and adds a new line in the before and after the address element, and it should be in italic form. You can easily understand that the paragraph is related to the address. So likewise, we can do in your web pages. And next we will have a site, which is a tag which is used to get the title of the work. For example, if your article will be of a poem or song or a movie, you can easily specify that things in a different manner. Like we can use this site tag. So example, creative work may be of a book or poem or a song or movie or painting or sculpture. So if a person name is not to be title of work thing will be a different from the person's name. So the text in the site usually renders in italic. It will be the font will be an italic font, but in which conditions we are going to use, we can see here in this example. Here I am using a simple paragraph, and now here I am using a paragraph with a site. Here I am giving the scream. The scream is the painting. Here we can see the image of the painting. The painting by Edvard Munch, painted in 1893. This is a painting. This is a creative work which you have to highlight. Then you can use this site tag to make it as an italic form, and you can give a special preference to that content and that particular thing. This cream is a painting. So likewise, you can use the side tag to a painting or a poem or a song or a sculpture. Anything you can use this tag. make it as a special creative work. And next, you will have a tag called bidirectional override tag. This BDO stands for bidirectional override. Let us see what it means. This tag is used to override the current text direction. For example, this is your current text. This is where I have written. This text will be written from right to left. This content will be given in the bidirectional override. Here I am overriding the content by using this attribute, what is called dir. This attribute is very important. By using this attribute, I am gonna change the direction of the content which is specified in this tag. That is, I want a direction from right side. For right side, we have a value of RTL to right. So let us see how I am changing the content. We can see each and every letter will be a right shifted. You can see bidirectional, it is a opposite direction. We can change, or we can give it as a left, or we can remove it. You can give it as a left also. For left, FT, I think. Let's see how it will be. You can see it is in the proper order. For the left, it has given a correct order. If you can change it as a right, it will give in the opposite direction. So bidirectional is nothing but getting the things in a reverse fashion. So by using this bidirectional override tag, by using this attribute dir tag and giving value which type of direction do you want, you will get those type of directions for your content. You can see here, you can't read this content. So it is a bidirectional content and it is of right direction. So that is this tag all about BDO, bidirectional override. By this way, you can use to override the current text direction. Whatever the current text direction, we can change or override it. So that's all we have seen, and we can do with HTML exercises here present. Before that, we hear what they are asking. Use a simple HTML element to add quotation marks around the letters cool. In the cool, I have to add quotation marks. They are simply telling about quotation marks of a small, so we can use as a q, small q is enough. Before and after the cool, I am giving a q closing tag and the open tag we have given, and submit the answer, then you will get the things right. You can submit and your things will be going on. Yes, it's correct. You can go to the other exercises, then many more things we can use. Site tag here. If you are taking from another source, and this is all about exercises, you can see here. If up to now we have seen all about abbreviation tag and address tag and bidirectional override tag and block quote tag and site tag and q tag. Q tag is for short inline quotation, and for title of any creative work we have seen site tag, and for defining a section that is quoted from another source we have seen a block quote, and bidirectional to change the text direction we can use bidirectional override. For address, any contact information of about author or any owner of that site we can give by using this address, and abbreviation for giving any abbreviations or anything we use this ABBR tag. So that's we have seen up to today. If you wanna gonna take many tags running to cities, you can go through this link, which is the HTML tag reference. So you can have many tags in that. So up to now, what you have seen all about citations and different types of quotes and quotations we have. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching, and if you have any doubts regarding to this topic or any previous topics, you can feel free to comment in the comment session, and we will definitely reply to your comments. And if you like this video, give a big thumbs up below, and if you have subscribed to my channel, stay tuned to all our concepts. If you still not subscribe and click the bell icon below to get notified each time when we upload a new video, so that you will never gonna miss our concepts and videos which are coming ahead. And if your colleagues and friends are in search of any web developer site, suggest this site, and suggest our videos to get easy learning, and keep learning and keep smiling. Bye bye.